Okay. We're at chapter 18. Chapter 18. And now I'm moving to section 2. And section 2 is simply saving. Saving and investing. So, we begin with something, it's an important section, but it's very easy. So, we first say, what is a saving? Or savings, sometimes used in single, sometimes used in plural. And savings is very simple. It is saving is simply income.
If this, all this one is saving here, and then this is saving income, all this one.
Yes,
is
section 26.2, saving. You'll have to find it.
Because one class I missed, that's why.
You have to find it. Right now, I'm not saving. I'm explaining what is saving. Is income minus expenditure. Okay. Well, for the economy, what is the, for the whole economy, what is income? For the whole economy, what is income? We studied one chapter about income. Well, so question, what is the income for the overall economy? We studied it. You already had a quiz. The income is GDP. This is the income. This is the income. The economy in the income is GDP. This is all the income in the economy. Remember the first we began the course, we said that for the economy, all expenditures are equal to all income. And income in the economy, GDP, measures the total income of the economy, the same as total expenditure. Well, now, what is expenditure in the economy? Expenditure in the economy includes all consumption, money that you consumers spend. You eat, you drink, the electricity that you consume, the clothes, all of your expenditures. This is the expenditures, we say, of household. Okay. And what's on the other side? For the government, what is the government expenditure? Simply G. G. This is what the government spends on. Okay. So, we say in this particular case that savings equals GDP minus consumption minus government. Okay, so far fairly clear. Now the next part is the following. What is GDP? How do we write the GDP in chapter 1? What letter we use for GDP? What letter we use?
Y.
We use Y. So, we say that savings equals Y minus C, and because this is a minus sign, it becomes minus G. Okay. Well, that's the savings part. And now comes the other part. The other part was the original equation. What was the original equation about?
What the c plus g and then c plus minus g?
Because there is a minus sign in front of the expenditures. So it's minus both expenditures, minus the consumption, and then minus government spending. Now comes the next simple thing. Remember what was GDP equal to at the beginning?
Consumption
plus investment plus government spending, and we also had one net exports. Now, to make things just a little bit easy, but it's actually very easy to put the export part here, okay? We temporarily, just to make things easy, we just say, well, for the moment, let's just ignore the exports, okay? The net exports. Now, the question is, what is investment? Now, this, if you remember, we use it like this, is always true. Being three lines means it's always true. It is an identity. Here, when we say savings, savings is all simply equal to income minus expenditure. So, if your salary is 20,000 and expenditure same as spending, you spend 15, your saving is 5. Okay. So, what is investment equal to? From here, what is investment equal to here?
Government.
So you got an equation. GDP. Oh, becomes GDP. Y.
Minus
C.
Minus G.
Minus C. Minus G. Now, if you like, you can add here minus X. Okay. So this is what we got here. We got that y equals minus y minus c minus g. Well, what do we have here for s?
Then why will not include x as a minus?
Just to make it a little easier for you. Now, if you like, we can just say here minus x if you want it more complicated and more difficult. But I'm just trying to explain something amazingly simple, okay? So, what was S again? S, repeat.
GDP minus C.
Is Y minus C minus G. Well, from these two, what can you conclude?
It's maybe equal.
Investment is the same as savings. In other words, we say savings equals investment. So before I just mentioned it on the chapter for economic growth, I mentioned that the government should encourage investments, and the way to encourage investments is to encourage saving. More spending is bad for growth. More saving is good for growth. Okay, so the first little question that you write was, why is saving equal to investment? And then the second part, why is savings important? So, why is it equal? Because savings, by definition, is simply equal to income minus expenditure, which is equal to this part. You can add here minus x if you like, okay?
If we want.
Yes, it doesn't matter. Again, so I'm just trying to make, keep it.
The equations. In the answer, we should write the equations.
Well, it's a good, simple and easy answer, yes. But you first have to define savings. What does savings mean? It means it's the same for government, it's the same for you, the same for me, and it's also the same for a business, for any business. Businesses save money. Okay. Yes.
For the second question, why saving is important, the answer will be?
The answer is, I already said it and I'll repeat it for you. Because increased savings means increased investment, and higher investment means higher capital.
Increased saving means increased.
Increased investments, and higher investments means higher capital, higher productivity,
and
higher growth, and higher standard of living. This is exactly the same you already wrote on the chapter of growth. You already wrote the whole thing. Higher investment, you need to find it.
Higher investment.
So, higher savings means higher investments. Higher investment means higher capital. More capital means rising
productivity.
And rising productivity means higher production,
higher saving, higher discipline.
Yes. K is capital. Capital. Capital.
Why is K?
K is
capital C.
Well, in economics, capital, we use the letter K. We cannot use C because C is already taken for consumption. Okay. So, capital is K. You're right that capital goes up. Now, if production is up, this means that GDP is up, and this means standard of living. Is up. Now, the way you understand it is very simple. Rising standard of living means you grow rich. It's all about being rich and getting rich. So, if you want as a society to grow more rich, you need to increase savings, investment, and all of it in order to raise your standard of living. Okay? So, that's why savings are important.
Excuse me, doctor, would you like the date because we can take a picture?
Yes, today's date is February 25, chapter 18, now section 2.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, the next very small and very little piece, which is part of this, is the G part. We have what's called a public saving. What does it mean, public saving? Again, it is government income minus government expenditure. In English, in economics, in finance, public here means government. Government. So, is equal to government income minus government expenditure. Now, government income, similar to business, is also called, just like you call it in accounting, government revenue. So, government income is the same as government revenue. Okay. Now, this difference between the two of them has a very special name. It's called simply government balance. Balance. Okay, and a balance, like any balance in business, finance, and accounting, a balance can be positive or it can be negative. It could be zero, but it practically never happens in the real world. Like, you can never balance your income to your expenditures. If you earn 7,000, maybe you spend 7,200, maybe you spend 6,995, right? It's never balanced. Maybe the difference is small, maybe the difference is large. So the difference is called balance. If the balance is positive, we call it surplus. Surplus is a positive balance. And we sometimes just call it government surplus. Okay. And if it's negative, we'll call it deficit. Yes, government deficit. Government deficit. Now, I will change a little bit the topic for 2 minutes to clarify something very simple. X is exports minus import, right? Okay. And export and import represent trade. And the difference between the export and import is called the balance. It's called trade balance. So the difference between them is the trade balance. Okay, so here you got the government balance, here you got the trade balance. Okay, now if it's positive, we call it, what's the name? If it's positive, right, remember, we got a lot of different surpluses. This one here is a government surplus.
Trade surplus.
Yes, trade surplus. Trade surplus. So, trade in a trade surplus, imports are greater than exports are greater than imports. Okay, it's simply the difference between exports and imports when exports are greater. Now, when the imports are greater, you have trade deficit. Yes, trade deficit means export is less than import, but we like to say that the imports are more than the export. You import more and you export less.
This is what all the governments are less. Does mean export is the same export is
no, government surplus, I already wrote it here. You need to read it. Is government revenue is greater than government expenditure.
Okay.
So the word surplus means what? What is the meaning of the word surplus?
The word?
More. Yeah, more. Yes. Like more than enough.
Yeah, more than enough. Now, how we call this in economics and finance? It's written there. How do we call it? Remember, I wrote the word
grow rich.
Balance.
Rich.
And I wrote here, no, plus sign. Surplus means positive balance. Positive balance. Deficit means negative balance. That's it. This is the meaning of surplus. Surplus means positive. That doesn't mean necessarily grow rich, and it could be a lot of things. Surplus means positive balance. That's what it means in finance and economics and accounting. Deficit means negative.
Victor, even it will be the convertible balance or the trade balance, you just say it is positive balance or negative balance.
Positive balance means surplus for anything and everything. This is the meaning of the word surplus. Deficit means negative balance. Now, you can have all sorts of deficits, okay? Financing deficits, funding deficits, government deficits, trade deficits, there could be thousands of different deficits. But in each deficit, the balance is negative. Okay? So, I explained this part. Now we're coming back to public saving. The public saving is simply equal to the government surplus or to the government balance. So, now what does it mean for growth? Growth. Let's write it out in good English. What meaning? Let's write it out nice and clear. Government surplus up means savings up means growth. Okay, so government surpluses result in higher savings and result in higher growth. Now, let's rewrite the opposite. Government deficits up. When the deficits go up, this means that the savings go down. And this means that the growth will go down. The question, right? You wanted to know the question is. The question is, why are government deficits bad for growth?
Why
are government deficits bad for, well, when we say growth, we mean economic growth. I don't mean any other growth, economic growth. That's the only thing we study here, economic growth. Why are government deficits bad for growth? Okay. Now, I can ask a little easier, why are government surpluses good for growth? But it's the same question, it just changed. Okay?
Because the answer will be the government, if the government deficit will be high, it will result to decrease in savings.
Yes, it will result in decreased savings. In this particular case, the savings have a special name. They're called public savings. So I could have written here public savings.
That means the public saving will decrease.
Yes, it will decrease.
It will result in decreasing in growth.
Right, so it will be resulting in overall growth. Okay, so far clear? Okay, let's see if I have anything else. The meaning of saving and investment. Okay, that's very good.